Hi, thanks for calling Glam Salon. How can I help you today?
Hey, this is Ray Newman. I want to make a booking for 9 a.m. tomorrow.
Thanks, Ray. What service would you like to book for 9 a.m. tomorrow? For example, cut, color, foils, blow dryer treatment?
I want to get a men's haircut.
9 a.m. tomorrow is available for a men's cut, Ray. Can I please have your email to complete the booking?
Yeah, my email is rayenewmanai@gmail.com.
All set, Ray. You're booked for a men's cut at 9 a.m. tomorrow, Monday, November 10th. You'll get a confirmation email shortly. See you then.
So I just got my Google invite, plus I got the email confirmation of my booking time. Now, voice agents are able to help you with your business. They're able to help you to capture any calls that you would otherwise miss. That's the power of voice AI, and it's only getting better. I've used Retell AI to create the voice AI, and I've integrated that with n8n. So let's go through exactly how I set it up. The first thing you want to do is create an account through Retell AI. It's really simple. They have a free trial, so you don't need to spend anything straight up. Just create an account. Once you've created your account, we're going to head over to agents, and we're going to create an agent. And today it's a voice agent. In the voice agent, we're going to go to single prompt agent, and then we're going to start from scratch. There's a few templates that you can work from, but let's start from scratch. I'm going to give you a prompt that you can use for your agent. Click create. Now go to the description to download the prompt, and we're going to paste it in here. I've just pasted my prompt in. You can easily generate something like this from ChatGPT, but it's structured out so that you can see the role, the goal, the services, the tools, which are like the functions. We'll go through that in more detail soon. The flow, how the conversation is going to happen, and then an example just so the AI understands how it should actually happen. So at the very start here, we're going to name our AI voice agent Sally, and she's the receptionist for Glam Salon. It can be any business that you like. I've also specified our time zone. I'm in Brisbane, Australia, so that's my time zone here. And I want to keep the replies short and sweet. And the goal here is that we want to book appointments. Very simple, nothing complicated here, and confirm the details. The services, well, this is a hair salon, so we've got men's haircuts, women's cuts, we've got color treatments. Each of these treatments have different times, but I've just assumed 1 hour to keep things simple. For the tools, we're going to introduce a few functions, so I'm going to walk you through exactly how to set that up. There's two functions that we're going to use, the check availability and the book appointments function. And then we've got our flow, like I was saying before, and then the example. So let's save this and let's talk about the environment in retail. So up the top here, you've got our agent name, and I'm just going to call this YouTube example. We've got our agent ID, our retail ID. We've got how much it costs per minute. We've also got the latency and then the tokens it costs. For now, we're going to use GPT 4.1. This is the brains behind it. You can choose whichever one you like. GPT 4.1 is fast and it's cheap, so that's the one I'm going to go with. You can also choose your custom voice. SEMO is a default. It's a popular one. You can pick anything you like. There's a whole bunch here to choose from. And then, of course, you've got the language as well. At the bottom here, you also want to choose that the AI responds first. So when you get a call, we've got the AI speaking first. Now let's add our functions. Under the functions tab, we're going to go to add, and we're going to add a custom function. The custom function name is going to be check availability. This is going to check our calendar for availability. We're going to post. We're going to link this up to n8n. So we're going to get this link in a second. This is the timeout. We don't need to worry about headers or query parameters. We're going to change our parameters optional to form. Add a parameter, and that's going to be time. We're going to check availability. Next, we're heading over to a platform called n8n. This platform is great because you can build flows, and this is how we're going to automate this whole thing. We're going to have our front end, which is Retell AI, and we're going to tie that in with the calendar and AI system that's going to check the bookings and book them in. And that's through Google Calendars. So let's set that up. There's a few ways to get access to n8n. One is the website that you just saw, n8n.io. And then the other way is self-host. That's what I do. You can save a bit of money. I get access through Railway, but a lot of people use hosting. I just had some really annoying issues trying to connect my Google account. I didn't even realize that it was hosting her. But after I went to Railway, no problems at all. So just pick one of those platforms if you want to self-host. Once you've got it set up, we're going to go create workflow. Like I was saying before, you need to hook up to the Google API Cloud. If enough of you guys want me to create a video about it, I can do that. But for now, I'm going to assume that you've been able to connect your Google account. We're going to start by creating our check booking workflow. So I'm going to change the title here to check booking YouTube demo. And we're going to create a webhook trigger. In here, we're going to change the HTML method to post. We're going to leave the respond to immediately. And then we're going to listen for a test event. We're going to copy this test URL. We're going to paste it up here into our post like that. Save this. Now we're going to select listen for test event. That's going to capture any details we send over. We're going to do a test call.
Hi, thanks for calling Glam Salon. How can I help you today?
Hey, I want to make a booking for 10 a.m. on Wednesday.
Of course. Which service would you like to book for Wednesday at 10 a.m.? For example, women's cut, color, blow dry, etc.
Why try a women's cut?
Thanks for letting me know you'd like a women's cut. I'm checking availability for Wednesday at 10 a.m. now. One moment, please.
Now you can see our webhook captured the data. I'm just going to hang up. Right down the bottom here, you can see the argument that it captured. This is the time, so this is what we want to copy over in our prompt. Now I'm going to create an AI agent. In here, we're going to change this to define below. I've got a prompt that you can paste in. Very simple prompt here. I've broken it down in a similar way to what we did in retail. You are an appointment availability checker. Use a calendar to see if the requested time can be booked. We've got to make sure that we're booking for now because it can easily book in the past. It's not going to help you unless you've got a time machine. So let's make sure that we're booking now or in the future. We've got the requested time, which is going to be that time that you just saw. I've already got the argument in here, which you saw from the previous window. I've made it clear here, never return past time, something I learned the hard way. And keep replies short and clear. That's the one thing that we really want is for AI to be simple. We don't want it to go into a monologue and bore people to death. We want to add our chat model. We're going to use OpenAI. And we're going to go with 4.1 mini again. It's really fast and it's cheap, so let's do that. I've also got to add my tool, which is the calendar for a check. In this calendar event, we're going to look at resources. We're going to look at the calendar. We're going to look for availability. I've just got to select my email address. The start time, we're going to let the model define. And we're also going to do the same for the end time. Like I was saying before, I just assume that all these events are going to take 1 hour to simplify things. It's going to book for 1 hour. That's why we can let the agent define the start and the end time. From there, I'll just execute this step and we should be able to get a result. And then I'll add my respond to webhook and I'm going to leave it in the default setting. I'm going to change the response to using respond to webhook node. And let's just double check if that works. Let's run this.
Hi, thanks for calling Glam Salon. How can I help you today? You're all set, Ray. Your foils appointment is booked for tomorrow, Monday, the 10th of November at 9 a.m. You'll receive a confirmation email shortly. Looking forward to seeing you.
Okay, that's pretty funny. It actually booked it without being able to book it, but it's checked my calendar. I've got nothing here, so I'm fully available. So the first part of this voice AI agent is done. We're going to add another custom function, and that's for the booking. We're going to call it book appointment, and this is going to make a booking to the calendar. We did the same thing before. We're going to create another workflow. We're going to have another webhook trigger. We're going to set it to post again. We're going to do the same thing where we call it. We're going to change this to form. This time we're going to have a name, the name of the customer. We're going to have our service type. That's the service requested by the customer. We're also going to have the time of the booking. Lastly, we're going to have our email of customer. Everything else is good. Let's save that. Now that the check availability is working, I'm going to switch it to active. And I'm also going to switch this to production mode. I'm going to update that in the function. So I'll replace this and update that. So now it's always running in the background. I don't have to turn it on and off. Now we'll double check the booking workflow is going to work. So I'll execute this workflow. Let's test it out.
Hi, welcome to Glam Salon. How can I help you today?
Hey, it's Ray Newman. I want to make a booking for Wednesday at 10 o'clock.
Thanks, Ray. Which service would you like to book for Wednesday at 10 a.m.? For example, cut, color, foils, blow dryer treatment?
I'll get a blow dry treatment this time.
Great choice, Ray. Wednesday at 10 a.m. is available for a blow dry and treatment. All set, Ray. You're booked for a blow dry and treatment on Wednesday, the 12th of November at 10 a.m. You'll get a confirmation email shortly. Looking forward to seeing you.
Okay, so we've got our data again, exactly the same way that we did it before. We're going to set up our AI agent. We're going to switch it to define below. And again, I've got the prompt that you can just copy straight over. We just paste that in here and I'll bring it up. So this time you are an appointment booking AI agent. Your job is to use the create an event in Google Calendar to collect the customer's details and create a calendar event or booking. The confirmation time is the time that they're gonna get from Retell AI. It's for 1 hour like we specified before. You use the confirm time as the start time, then set the end time 1 hour after. So it's pretty simple. And then if the event has been scheduled, you provide a response in this form. This is going to go back to Retell AI, and then Retell AI is going to receive that and then be able to confirm that verbally to the customer. So that's set up. Again, we're going to pick our OpenAI 4.1, which is default when you pick OpenAI. Next, we're going to get our calendar. This time around, we want to set it up for event. It's going to create an event. I'm going to set it up with my calendar. I'm going to let the model define the start and the end time just like we did before. You can just copy this from the file, just paste this in here. It's going to give you the details of the treatment. You're going to have to tweak it a little bit for the business that you're running. There's a bit of jargon here, but it simplifies what's going to come through. You can see here, it's going to bring in the name. It's going to bring in the type, the time, and the email address. It just doesn't have all those things yet. That's why it's coming in as red. For the location, you're going to put in your location. Mine is Brisbane, Australia. Last but not least, we're going to add a summary. We're going to use this as the title of our event. In my title, I'm going to have the name of the business, the treatment, and then also the name of the customer. That helps me to know who exactly it is for. The other thing we want to do is confirm it via email. So we're going to add another Gmail. So like I was saying before, you need to connect to the Google API to hook up your Google Calendar as well as your Gmail account. Happy to create a video. Just let me know in the description below if that's what you want. In here, we pull right down to the bottom to pull in the email address, who it's to. When you hover over it, you can see that it's pulling in my email address. You can call this email whatever you like. I'm going to call it an appointment booking confirmation. We want it in simple text. And if you like, you can just copy the text that I've written in the description. It says, hey, this is a confirmation that your time has been booked for this treatment on this day. We still haven't uploaded the day yet. Look forward to seeing you there. In this case, it's Glam Salon. And then we're going to respond to webhook. Respond to webhook, leave it on default. We also have to remember that we're going to switch this to using respond to webhook node. And then let's listen for the event and let's see if this whole thing works now.
Hi, thanks for calling Glam Salon. How can I help you today?
Hey, it's Ray Newman here. I want to book in for a men's haircut tomorrow at 9 p.m.
Thanks, Raymond. We close before 9 o'clock p.m. Would you like an earlier evening time or perhaps a morning or afternoon slot? Let me know your preference and I'll check what's available.
Yeah, I forgot that you guys close before 5. I want to make a booking for 1 p.m. tomorrow, please.
1 p.m. tomorrow is available, Raymond. Can I please have your full name and email to lock in your men's cut? I'll repeat your email back to confirm.
Yeah, my full name is Ray Newman and my email address is rayenewmanai@gmail.com.
Sorry, Ray, there was a technical issue booking your appointment. Would you like me to try again or would you prefer a different time? Let me know what works for you.
Try it again.
All set, Ray. You're booked for a men's cut tomorrow, Monday the 10th of November at 1 p.m. You'll get a confirmation email shortly. Looking forward to seeing you.
I just got the booking confirmation. Looks like I got to fix up some text, but you got the general idea. And similar to before, we're going to copy over our production URL and we're going to update our function. So that's the booking agent. Paste that in, update, and then we can publish, and you're all set with your voice AI agent Receptionist. Now, voice AI is really powerful. It still doesn't fully replace people, but it's going to help you to capture any missed calls that your business would have otherwise. So in that sense, it's definitely better than nothing. Now, if you want to set up something like this in your business, feel free to book a time with me and we'll go through exactly what you need. Otherwise, like and subscribe and stay tuned for next week. I've got another banger for you. Cheers.